What does success mean to you?
Success means, there are two things I would say. In Zentangle, I'm successful in a way that I can, you know, find myself there, as in I'm doing what I'm loving. I do what I love, that is my passion. But yes, the success monetarily, it might not be there right now for me. It's gradually coming in. But both the things are success to me, monetarily also, and you know. But yeah, obviously, if someone asked me to, you know, choose between IT and my painting, I would obviously leave IT, because I know if I'm doing something with, you know, my full heart, I'll definitely, you know, succeed in all the ways I could.
God forbid, but say you do not get money and in Zentangle, if mm-hmm. you, once you take it up full time, God mm-hmm. forbid, mm-hmm. will you be devastated?
Maybe initially, yes, because as a human nature, I think everyone will get that. You cannot be, you know, okay, it's okay. Ultimately, you have to do that. You have to just move on. But yeah, at that moment of time, you'll definitely feel devastated and you'll feel that, okay, I should leave that and get back to IT. But I don't think I'll do that ever. If I'm full time into Zentangle, once I decide doing that, I'll stick to that.
No, I am asking you this because we women, married women, we always, or rather women in general, we always have, either we had our fathers before marriage or after marriage we have our husbands, right? And we always have that thing that, okay, there's somebody earning, so we can always fall back on
yes.
that, on them.
Yeah.
Do you think that is one of the reasons why we women are so laid back when it comes to taking a business, or, you know, taking the business to the next level, mm-hmm. and about risks and everything?
Yeah, absolutely. I feel that, because I'm saying this because I've seen a lot of, women who are having immense talent, but they don't have that right skill to set up their own business and, you know, how to take it. You need to have that business mind and you need to take it forward that way. Many women are not doing because of that, and they are like, okay, we have a backup at home and we don't have any other issues, so it's okay, we'll just do it for hobby and keep pursuing that. Yeah, that's a major flaw, I would say, in us, maybe.
Do you think that's one of the reasons why art, or when you say a woman entrepreneur is selling her stuff or however, whatever that may be, is sold at a lesser price?
I would not generalize it, because there is category of, you know, women who are doing pretty well in that, and there are, you know, people who are actually just laid back only because they are not proactive enough to sell their art. So I have come across some people who are actually doing it very well and they are earning a lot with their art, whatever art they do. But I know people who are actually having immense talent and they're just wasting their talent. So I don't want to generalize this. It's, you know, as a woman, it's like that. It all depends on individual, actually.
So what, according to you, is a business mind?
You need to be proactive enough. You need to go out, network, you need to speak. You should have that, you know, skill to sell your stuff, whatever it is. It's food, it's art, it's anything. You should have that right skill. Why people should buy it from you? You need to convince people, because not everyone will be open to new ideas as such. But yeah, networking and going out of your house and, you know, meeting and establishing yourself, that is very important.
No, we women in general, we are shy. So the moment you tell anybody that you have to go out and speak, so the whole fact of stepping out of your house and to speak to strangers is itself a very challenging thing. For women in general.
Yes.
So, because I have seen a lot of them like not taking it forward. So, what do you have to tell them?
So, we do have, we are fortunate enough to be in this social media world. That is the best thing you can do. You don't have to talk to anyone. You just can, you know, open your seller account and start selling. But at least that much effort you need to do. You need to go through everything. What are the terms, condition? You should not. What I have seen, lot of women are not very clear with the ideas of selling, pricing, taxes, and because of that major hurdle, like registering you as a company or whatever it is, that is always pushing them back. Oh, who will do it? Someone will come and do it for us. We'll just post the pics. That is the attitude right now, which at least this much anyone can do, given that we have this exposure to social media. Yeah, so for people who are not, you know, confident enough to go out and speak, they should start with this at least.
And it's the social media part. Yes. And how about the pricing? Because the moment you talk to me about a GST on pricing, I will go bonkers with the numbers, right?
Yeah.
So how does one do the whole mathematical part of selling or you know, pricing?
Okay. So what I usually do is first you need to do a market study. What kind of art is getting sold? Who is your target audience? So depend and where you are selling. So if I'm selling at a high-end hotel and everything, obviously it will be a little bit overpriced. Plus if I have to pay some, you know, location charges and all that, that all those things you need to account for. But for that you need to do a lot of research and, you know, groundwork. Your material cost, your efforts, obviously you're designing something unique. So how much would you want it to sell for? So that all depends on an individual. If you are fine to sell it for a lower price, it's always good. But main thing is you should at least start.
Okay. All right, we're going to play a very quick game with Neha. It's called Risky Business. Ready, Neha?
Yeah.
A quick rapid fire.
Ooh.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay, have you ever had to bribe someone to get your work done?
No.
No?
No.
Okay, that was quick. Have you ever had to lie to get something done that you felt was good for your work?
Yeah.
No. Okay. Have you ever felt guilty about leaving a loved one and working?
Yeah.
I assume it's the daughter.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, if you got to choose between family and business, what would that be?
Tough one. Family with only painting, no business.
If a genie can grant you one wish, what would that be?
Make money out of art and improve the art scene in India.
Okay. You were standing at the edge of a cliff and there is a beautiful pond on the other side. Mm-hmm. You could jump in or turn back. If you jump in, you could see a magical world underwater and no one has ever seen that before, but you could also drown. If you turn back, you'll be safe. What would you do?
I'll jump for sure.
That was really quick.
Yeah. Jump for sure. As soon as you said magical world, I thought I will jump.
What does magic mean to you?
I don't know, magic can be anything, wherever, you know, something unexpected that is very good, which you like, you would want to see it, something good, in terms of good, not a black magic.
Okay, you said that everybody can do Zentangle.
Yes.
I want you to teach me today.
Absolutely.
Right? Yeah. In the next segment.
Cool.
One message that you would want to give our viewers, what would that be?
I would just say, don't shy away from drawing. Grab your pen, grab your paper and start tangling. Trust me, it's the best thing to do.
Thank you so much, Neha, for coming. It was wonderful having you.
Thank you. My pleasure. My pleasure.
So ladies and gentlemen, did you see that? Take that leap. Take that leap of faith, because the eighth period might just work for you. Goodbye for now.